This team has not flinched despite the fact that they are battling injuries. Their quarterback getting knocked around tonight. You can't say enough about the character of this program.
Downfield, it's Pittman. He goes up the ladder to get it.
Slovis, deep shot. Tyler Vaughn. USC will grab that victory bell and bring it back.
Fink able to slip the first man. Lofting to the end zone. Adjustment and a catch. Amon-Ra St. Brown. Magic happening for Matt Fink.
Slovis down the middle in stride. 95 yards.
Biggest threat is right down the middle.
And you got Slovis, who's got a first quarter record because of it.
Fight on, Trojans fans. In the Holiday Bowl, USC will match up against Iowa. For this squad, it's their third appearance in this bowl game. All of them actually coming since 2014. SC riding a four-game winning streak. Actually, the 10th all-time matchup between USC and Iowa. Trojans have won 7 of the previous 9 meetings. Got to go back to that most recent one. Remember that iconic 2003 Orange Bowl? Heisman Trophy winner Carson Palmer led SC. They dominated that game 38-17. And for more, the head coach of the Trojans, Clay Helton, is with us now. Coach, all right, the immediate reaction, you know it's Iowa, you know it's the Holiday Bowl. How do you feel about the game?
Man, excited to be able to go down to San Diego and play a really, really good Iowa team. You know, you talk about playing a Kirk Ferentz team that, you know, is one of the leaders of our profession, one of the best coaches in the history of the game. And then you look at the quality of his team, the quality of that top 20 defense. You're playing a team that's like us, really hot right now, had a great finish down the stretch. It makes for a really great matchup and should be great right here in Southern California. We're happy about it.
Coach, you have so many players returning, and now you get 10, 12, 15 odd bowl practices. I just would like, if you reflected on the season, I'm curious how you have held this thing together. You lost your quarterback in the second quarter of the opener, 5 running backs, I mean, a litany of players. How have you done it?
Well, you know, you're only as good as the men that surround you. And when you talk about this staff and these players, you know, this is a family and we bonded together. And it's a young family. You know, a lot of freshmen and sophomore out there, some of them got hurt. We kept on going. The next guy stepped up and fulfilled his job. And you look at the stretch run that we had, I couldn't be more proud of a group of kids. That future is so, so bright. And I look forward to watching these kids continue to grow. And now we've got the opportunity, you know, in this bowl game to really take a next step on a national level, you know, against a really quality opponent in Iowa.
Coach, you've now been at the helm for a couple seasons. Yogi and I, before we came out here, we were thinking about some of the signature bowl wins. We've been doing this show for, well, this is our 8th season now, and the two of us just keep circling back to your guys' win a few years ago against Penn State in the Rose Bowl. I know, obviously, it's the Holiday Bowl, so it's got a different bit of a vibe, but Yogi just made reference to a lot of the adversity. Just speak to the fact that your team closes out 4-game winning streak, a bunch of wins on the road. You told us how you were able to keep it together, but I'm just curious for, like, the mental fortitude. Just how proud you are of this team compared to some of the other ones that you've had since you've been in Southern California.
Yeah, you know, to have a group of kids truly believe in the process and believe in what we stand for and where we're headed, it was very rewarding personally as a coach. You know, I've always said I've got 3 children by birth, 110 I get the honor to adopt, and to watch your adopted sons grow up before your eyes and really do something what I thought was special down the stretch and really put their foot down and say, you know what, this team is going to be special in the future. It was neat to see, and it was neat to be a part of.
Coach Mike Bone came on our show a couple days ago, and he talked about you obviously coming back. And I looked at one of your quotes that you made in your statement coming back, and it was how it's abundantly clear that we now have the support, resources, and tools to build a championship team. Take us inside being a head coach. You know, what does that mean, and what resources, tools will you now have at your disposal?
Yeah, you know, I got the opportunity to sit down with President Folt and Mike Bone, and it just blew me away how supportive and how giving they want to be to this program. They see how close that we are, and they want to take us to the next step in every way, shape, and form, from staffing, from resources, to tools, to be able to get us to a championship level, and we're really, really close. You know, they've upgraded facilities here. They've supplied us with the resources to keep quality staff. They're doing the things that attract 18-year-olds. And you know what? It couldn't make me more happier. I've always felt that this is the pinnacle of college football. It's the most special place on earth. And to have the leadership of a President Fold and a Mike Bone saying, you know what, coach, tell me what you need to get there. And that makes you feel pretty good as a head coach.
Clay, you mentioned 18-year-olds. Yogi and I are going to be back on this set December 18th. We're going to be talking about your class and everyone's class in the Pac-12 Conference. You're trying to get some more players to get back to in the conversation for national championship. Paint the picture on how recruiting is going right now.
Yeah, going really well. You know, this is a smaller class for us, and everybody's got to realize that. You know, we have not had a ton of attrition. You know, you're looking at only 7 seniors total, you know, in this class. This is a very young group, and we won't be able to sign a total 25 kids this year. You know, so from the national rankings or spotlight, you know, it may not look up, oh, there's the number one class, but it will meet our needs, and we're addressing those needs out on the road right now. I'm literally going to get off this set and hop in a car and go get a home visit, and I got a plane flight early tomorrow morning. So recruiting never stops around here. It's what's your lifeblood for success. And thank goodness over the past couple of years, you look at this young talent around us, the players in this nation want to come play with these guys because they see, you know, the special qualities that these young men have here.
Clay, you know that there are USC fans that are mad at me and Yogi right now because we are keeping you from your task at hand, which is trying to go and get some of those guys. So appreciate the time. Pull out the IFB, go catch that flight and get some kids.
Sounds great, guys. Fight on.